the new inductees of Phi Theta Kappa. Advisor of the Alpha Romeo chapter of Phi Theta Kappa and a professor of English here at Lone Star College Tomball. It is my pleasure to welcome you to this very important and beautiful ceremony, a ceremony that's designed to recognize the academic achievement of these students who are to be inducted tonight and to Phi Theta Kappa, the International Honor Society of the two-year college. But before we proceed, I'd like to introduce our dignitaries sitting on the stage. First is our amazing college president, Dr. Leanne Nutt. And so, Phi Theta Kappans, how do we greet our incredibly awesome president? One wolf.
One bat.
One wolf.
One bat.
We are also privileged to have our distinguished vice president of instruction, Dr. Quentin Wright. So, Phi Theta Kappans, what do we say to our VPI, who is a fiercely supportive chapter advocate? One chapter.
One goal.
One chapter.
One goal.
Also on stage is our keynote speaker, the brilliant and much decorated Chapter President Emeritus and Jack Kent Cook Transfer Scholar, Mr. George Torres. All right, and first, let me introduce now the leadership team, the chapter co-advisor, Dr. Bill Simpson. Our chapter officers, Charles Kivlin. Communication, Mariah McBride. Vice President of Service, Chavi Nguyen. Vice President of Fellowship, Tri Tran. And filling in tonight for two of our officers who are on their honors trip, our two 2016 Geist White Scholars, Maria Gonzalez Trevino and Tiffany Avalos Lopez. We have filling in for them acting officers Adam Garner and Sam Dickerson. Tonight we also have some special guests within the Phi Theta Kappa Texas region. I don't know if Ivan's made it yet because of the traffic from HCC, but I know that our LSC Sci Fair compatriots are here. Dr. Blake Ellis, will you stand please? Lorenzo, and Ali Fawaz. I don't know if anybody's, has the blend made it yet? Blend folks are on their way from Brenham, so we want to recognize Beta Alpha Michael Florer and Chelsea Phelan. They'll be here in a little bit. We are also fortunate to have many faculty, staff, and administrators here tonight. All of you are such an important part of our student success. Will you please stand and be recognized? Also, a ceremony of this magnitude takes the effort of many people. I don't have the time to recognize everyone, but I do want to personally thank Dr. Nutt and her office team, Jackie Shepherd, Trudy White, and Donna Fitzpatrick. We literally could not put on this ceremony without their aid. And thanks to chapter alumni Linda Bancroft and Irene Briggs for their assistance in tonight's ceremony. Now please join me in giving a warm welcome to our wonderful college president, Dr. Leanne Nutt.
Thank you, Dr. Tate. And thank you for the one wolf, one pack thing. That was the best I think I've ever heard it done. So thank you, that did my heart good. And I'm so glad we didn't have tornadoes or floods or 10 inches of rain yet. If they could just stay away for a couple more hours, I'll be very happy about that. And I'm just pleased to see our beautiful Performing Arts Center packed to the gills with new inductees and family and friends and our faculty and staff who are here. It truly is one of my highlights of the semester to see so many of our inductees here. So I'm happy to extend my congratulations to all the new members And it is my decided pleasure to be the first to tell you congratulations. Congratulations on your commitment to academic excellence and on your induction into this honor society. You've worked hard, you've achieved this honor, you deserve this honor, and this evening is about celebrating you, because at Lone Star College Tomball, we do strive to make it about you, your academic achievement and dedication. I would also like to briefly comment on the quality of your chapter's history of distinguished success, because it does merit mention. If you'll refer to your program, you'll see that Alpha Rho Mu is recognized on the international, regional, and campus levels. In fact, in 2015, the Alpha Rho Mu chapter received 26 awards on the international and Texas region levels, including being named the 2015 Most Distinguished Chapter in all of Phi Theta Kappa. So what that means is Alpha Rho Mu is recognized as the top chapter in the entire world. That's pretty neat. We were also named the 2015 Most Distinguished Chapter in the Texas region, and was named the Most Outstanding Student Organization at LSC Tomball. And 2 weeks ago, at the Texas Regional Convention, Alpha Rho Mu was named the 2016 Most Distinguished Chapter in Phi Theta Kappa Texas region, the second year in a row. Let's clap for that. The level of commitment and dedication on behalf of your student Phi Theta Kappa officer team, advisors, faculty, and staff, it takes everybody to achieve this level of success, and I couldn't be prouder of the recognition that has come to our college and to the students, and now to you as new members of Alpha Rho Mu. So congratulations, inductees. I'm proud to welcome you as new members of the Alpha Rho Mu chapter of Phi Theta Kappa at Lone Star College Tomball. One woof.
One woof.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nutt. As always, it is an honor and a privilege to have you with us tonight. Today, Phi Theta Kappa has chapters, Phi Theta Kappa, the Honor Society, the two-year college, has chapters not only in every state of the Union, but in Canada, Europe, Asia, the Middle East, and South America. Phi Theta Kappa was founded in 1918 in Missouri by a group of community college presidents who were committed to recognizing and encouraging academic excellence and to providing community college students with opportunities for leadership development, for service, for fellowship, and for scholarship. These ideals continue to be the hallmarks of the members of Phi Theta Kappa. Our chapter, Alpha Rho Mu, was founded at Lone Star College Tomball in 1990 and has, as Dr. Nutt noted, a history of distinguished success that is founded in service. Whether chapter members are making blankets for the elderly, whether we are teaching the scientific method to elementary school children using Oreos, or whether we are bringing world-famous scientists to campus to share cutting-edge cancer treatment and to bring hope to late-stage cancer patients. True to our chapter's history of excellence and service, the students who are to be inducted tonight into this chapter are Lone Star College Tomball's finest students. These individuals have earned the honor of membership through their academic excellence, and membership is by invitation only. That invitation is extended by our college president, Dr. Leanne Matt. It is the hope of the chapter's leadership that many of those who will be inducted tonight will choose to also be active and join us in these endeavors. To the inductees, as chapter president, it is my honor to officially congratulate you and welcome you to membership in Alpha Rho Mu, the Lone Star College Tomball chapter of Phi Theta Kappa. Now, Mariah will tell you a little bit about Phi Theta Kappa programming.
Once inducted, new members can choose extracurricular chapter involvement through the five-star chapter plan, which provides its members avenues for individual growth and development in the hallmarks. There are, in fact, two projects that Phi Theta Kappa International requires of its five-star chapters, and it is on the quality of these two projects that our international and Texas regional rankings are based. One of these is the College Project, which focuses on institutional service and stresses collaboration between the chapter and the college administration. For its 2015 college project, Alpha Rho Mu collaborated with Dr. Nutt in the campus-wide emphasis on grit, growth, resilience, instinct, and tenacity. In the G3 initiative, Grit, Growth, Greatness, the chapter was asked by Dr. Nutt to spread the importance of grit into the community. In doing so, the chapter worked closely with the high school children of the Boys and Girls Country, a residential facility for children in crisis. The other required program in the five-star system is the Honors in Action Project, which is centered on academic research into a society-determined topic, which is centered on academic research. And once a chapter selects its theme and completes its research, its members apply that research to create a project that fulfills a need within the community. The 2015 topic was Frontiers and the Spirit of Exploration. Alpha Rho Mu selected as its theme Frontiers in Health and Medicine. After researching the frontier of cancer, the chapter collaborated with doctors Jim Allison and Pam Sharma from MD Anderson Cancer Center to create a seminar to explain the science of immunotherapy, in particular, immune checkpoint blockade cancer therapy, and to provide outreach to late-stage cancer patients of the hope available through clinical trials. By fulfilling these requirements, Alpha Rho Mu has once again achieved five-star status, but more importantly, demonstrated its commitment to meaningful institutional and community service. And now we'll have the opportunity to hear the official Phi Theta Kappa song, sung by the Lone Star College Tomball Concert Choir singers, accompanied by Miranda Wilborg, and directed by Dr. Lisa Morales, the director of the Lone Star College Tomball Music Program. Please give them a warm welcome. Dr. Bill Simsek, introduce our keynote speaker for this evening. Thank you.
Time tonight that I will have the microphone, I'd like to say congratulations also to the inductees and advise each of you to remember you cannot achieve success to any real degree alone. It takes friends, family, mentors, and a prevailing spirit. Please don't let tonight's achievement be your greatest. As Dr. Tate tells her students at the end of class, go out into the world and find happiness and success. And I would add, do it with kindness. Our speaker tonight, George Torres, is eminently qualified to address our Phi Theta Kappans since he, during his short stay here at Lone Star College Tomball, came in like a lamb and left like a lion. He mentored each of us in the process. George Torres is the recipient of the prestigious Jack Kent Cook Scholarship. He is a Coca-Cola Gold Scholar, a Phi Theta Kappa Distinguished Officer, and was a crucial part of the officer team of our Alpha Romeo chapter when it was named the number one chapter internationally in Phi Theta Kappa out of almost 1,300 chapters. The only time this has been achieved in the history of Lone Star College, Tomball, so far. He initially came to Tomball to pick up some coursework in order to get a better job. And after catching the intellectual bug of curiosity for which there is no cure, he decided to pursue and is now finishing his bachelor's degree at the University of St. Thomas. And he now has his eye on graduate work in literature and I believe is in the process of becoming an academic in the purest and most respectful sense of the word. George is no longer preoccupied with life's external pursuits. He is engaged in lifelong internal pursuits of knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. Leaders, it is said, are born, not made, and I do believe George is a born leader. This could be a product of some biology, as many would associate with being born with something. But I think his leadership style is actually a product of his introspective nature. Here's what I think are some of his secrets to success. He is critical of himself, but he is complimentary of others. He does not buy into the illusion of raising oneself up by lowering those around you. In fact, he raises himself to greater heights by raising those around him. He absolutely does not shrink away from a debate, but in the debate he remains fair, focused on the issues, and remains impersonal in his language. He also does not simply let things be. If there's injustice or unfairness, he approaches it much like a shark approaches fresh blood. He is not a leader that delegates, but a leader that demonstrates and models not just the work, but the work ethic. George does not look externally for models to imitate in his life. He seeks internally the model for his life. And finally, I believe that he is successful because he cares. He cares for his family, for his cat, even though he would not admit it. And he cares for his friends and his community. I'm honored to call George a friend and thankful for his time here at Lone Star College Tomball, his time in my class, and his work with Alpha Romeo. Last year, his officer team took our Alpha Romeo chapter to number one in Texas and number one internationally. And by winning many other international awards, they set the bar very high for this year's officers. But as a demonstration of how success breeds success, our officer team this year took the baton from last year's team and have carried it forward, with being named at the Texas Regional Conference just a few weeks ago, top chapter in Texas with the top officer team, top member, and top officer. These are very good signs, and while I would like to reference our standing internationally, those awards have not yet been handed down. I would be remiss if I didn't say that I have high hopes of Alpha Romeo being named top chapter internationally for the second year in a row. And that has only occurred about twice in the last 98 years of operations for Phi Theta Kappa International. We will find out next month at the Phi Theta Kappa International Convention in Washington, D.C. So George, thank you for setting the bar high, for being a model leader, and for remaining connected to your Phi Theta Kappa chapter, Alpha Romeo. Please welcome George Torres.
No pressure. Those were very kind words, Dr. Simpson. Thank you very much. But you are wrong on one count. I did have role models, and you were one of them. The risk of sounding sappy. What he doesn't tell you is that there was a pretty rocky start. And like any good English major, I'm going to start in medio res, which means in the middle of the action. It was August 27th. It was a little past 6:30 p.m. I was sitting in my pickup truck in the south lot, and it was the very first day of classes in the fall 2012 semester. I had enrolled as a part-time student, and I was terrified. I couldn't get out of my truck. I sat there. I watched people get out of their vehicles and go into the south building. And then finally, I made myself open the door and I stepped out, and my knees almost gave out. I was worried that everybody would know that I was a dummy, that I didn't belong in college, and I was terrified that professors were going to think, what is this guy doing here? That maybe I was just the guy paying money for no reason. But to understand why I followed up, to understand why I thought those things, to understand why that had that much of a negative outlook, we have to go all the way back to when I was getting ready to graduate high school. I'm not going to tell you what year that was, because that would just be kind of embarrassing. But to give you some general idea, VHS was still a thing, and people used something called landlines. So, I couldn't wait to get out of high school. I'd had a couple of bad experiences, and I just was tired of people maybe thinking I wasn't a very smart guy, and that I just didn't like being looked down on, and I wanted for nothing more than to get out of high school, get a job, and get out of my parents' house. Nobody in my immediate family had gone to college, much less graduated college, so I didn't really have a role model there. And whenever I would hear, well, you can go to college and you can be whatever you want, that just didn't seem real to someone like me. So I worked. I worked a long time. I worked in many different fields, and I remember the last serious full-time job that I had. Man, I thought I made it. I had a cubicle. I had my own phone. A phone number that was on a business card that had my name on it. I was no longer an hourly guy. I was a salaried guy. I thought, this is it. And I did it without having to go to a fancy university and get a piece of paper. So I was very proud of myself, but as the years wore on, I got frustrated. I got frustrated because the company would bring in guys from the outside into prominent positions that I tried for and I didn't get. I remember seeing guys pass me up, and my attitude was a pretty ugly one. I would think things like, well, these guys, well, they're just, you know, sucking up to the boss, or maybe it's a race thing, or any number of ridiculous excuses I indulged in, and I grew more frustrated. And I would think to myself, these clowns only get this because they have that paper. But you know what the truth of the matter is? Those guys put the work in to get that degree. They did. So if they're clowns with degrees, then what was I? That's not a truth that a lot of people like facing up to. And you can handle it one of two ways. You can be positive about it and try to do something to rectify it. Or you can continue to wallow in that negativity and let it eat you away. And I did that for a while. I'm not proud to say that. But yeah, that was the truth. So I decided to enroll in school, but I didn't really think about it. And it wasn't until I was sitting in the truck that day, before the very first class I had to take, that every fear that I had when I was in high school, why I didn't want to go to class, just came crashing down on me. Especially when it came to math. I was not the best math student in high school, and that's putting it mildly. When I took the entrance exam to get into LSU Tomball, I tested into the very bottom. I was told by my advisor, you were going to have to take three levels of developmental math just so you can get up to college level math. It was a mountain that doubled the size of Everest as far as I was concerned. It seemed almost impossible. And I had the wrong attitude when it came to interacting with others. I didn't want to talk to anybody. I didn't talk to any fellow students. I didn't talk to the professors. I didn't want them to know that I felt this way. I didn't want them to discover that I didn't know what I was doing. And I handled it badly. And I remember I was leaving class, and there was a woman on a bench, and she had these notebooks open on her lap, and it looked like math work, and she was crying. And I don't know why, but I stopped and I said, well, are you okay? She didn't say anything. She just looked at me like, please leave. And I don't know if she was crying because it was something else personal or if it was just the frustration from doing that work. But I thought, if it is that work and she is crying, Jesus, she really is invested in this. It matters enough to her for her to cry. Why am I not that invested? Why am I not putting that kind of effort in? If I'm going to do this, why am I not doing it with every fiber of my being? I changed after that. I started reaching out to my professors. I started asking for advice. I started saying, well, look, I've got this problem. I've got all these developmental math classes I've got to take. You know, what can I do? And I started reaching out to other students, and I learned, well, I'm not the only one that deals with these things. You know, when you get, you're so self-absorbed, you don't see all of these other people that have had it worse off than you. And I started hearing other people's stories and getting to know them, and I realized, you know, I really should stop complaining about things and just get to work. I took 0306, which is the lowest level math, in a semester, and when I finished it, I thought, you know, I'm just going to roll right into a mini-mester and do 0308, which was the following sequence. That, a mini-mester, by the way, is like 3.5 months worth of work in 3 weeks. I remember waking up, like having night terrors, screaming algebraic expressions. No, that, you laugh, but that happened. You know, and I remember, you know, if you, and you can check the records in the library if you don't believe me, run my student ID number over there. I was living in the Extended Learning Center for a while. I remember I was sitting at a table once, and a bunch of students came in, and they came and they sat down at my table, and they said, hey, can you help us with this? I said, I am not the tutor you were looking for. You probably know more than I do. And but that's how much time I spent in there. When I was done with 0308, I immediately rolled into 0310. My very first test, this was a 5-week course, a summer course, that started immediately after 0308. My first test was a 71, and I remember thinking, oh, well, here's the wall again. So I went right back to living in the Extended Learning Center. I think after a while, I was almost like a son to the lady that worked there, because I was in there so much. But I did all three of those in 6 months, and I rolled into College Algebra that following fall. And that class turned out to be probably one of the easiest classes I've ever taken, and that's not bragging, because I don't like to do that. That is the reality of how much work I put into it. And I remember thinking, I was scared of this. I mean, not that I'm bragging or anything, but I've been jumped. I've been held up at gunpoint. I almost run off the freeway one time by a guy. I still don't know what his problem was. And I was scared of math, you know? Come on. But that confidence that I developed started spreading towards other things. I started thinking, well, maybe I can try honors classes. You know, I associated honors with eggheads, people that looked down on me, people that was a dummy. And I thought, well, no, I've already slayed one dragon. Maybe I should take a swing at another one. And I'm glad that I did. My first honors class was with Dr. Rebecca Tate. And that was the beginning of a direction in life for me. Dr. Simsek mentioned that I was just there to maybe get some skills or pick up a workforce degree. But that's when I saw her mentoring other students and I saw the effort that she put in there, I thought, you know, I like doing this. I like helping other people. It was a change from having been in an office environment or having been in this place where all I thought about was myself. And I remember I was inducted into Phi Theta Kappa fall of 2013. And I thought, you know, I'm really busy with my academics. I'm not going to really get involved. It seemed like a whole thing, a whole lot of work, and I'm not going to get a grade for it, you know. There was that selfishness still peeking up, even though I was starting to turn the corner. And in the fall, in the spring of 2014, Dr. Tate approached me and said, you know, we have the honors in action as a part of Phi Theta Kappa. I really think you should lead it. And I thought, wow, this is a really complex project with a lot of components and no grade. Nah, I think I'm good. No, George, I really think you should do it. I think you get a lot out of it. See, Phi Theta Kappa, what they don't tell you, Phi Theta Kappa provides fantastic opportunities to travel, to go to workshops and seminars, both at a local level, at a state level, and an international level, with the crown jewel of Phi Theta Kappa's programming, which is called the Honors Institute. It's a week-long series of seminars and lectures, and a chance for you to meet not just people from the Texas region, but people from all over the world, and to hear amazing, inspiring lecturers, and to get an idea of the types of projects you can do. You heard them mention the project that they did this year with Jim Allison and his work on immunology. We tackled a project that was in a similar vein. We looked at and explored unconventional medical treatments for post-traumatic stress syndrome and for chronic pain due to injury as it pertains to military veterans. For those of us that were on the officer team at the time, this was a meaningful project because many of us had family members that were serving or had served and were suffering from these things, that we were able to win, that the society thought that our project, which we just felt was more of a labor of love for our community and for our college, that we were able to win overall. That was the grade that I had selfishly looked for, but by that point I had no longer cared. I was happy being a part of Phi Theta Kappa. You know, Dr. Simpson was mentioning my leadership skills. You know, you want to know the truth? All those things that I accomplished because I was helped by a lot of people along the way. And one of those was a fellow student, and I don't think she's here tonight, but she was the president of PTK before I took over. Her name was Heba Ramadan. I saw her as a wallflower, someone that was very kind and soft-spoken, and I thought, you're the president? You're going to bring these people with such diverse backgrounds and such different ideas together? And you're going to manage all these ambitious projects that we have? Good luck with that. Dr. Tate had faith in her, and I was wrong. She turned out to be a force of nature. I had a chance to witness her transformation from what I thought was this soft-spoken person into one of the best leaders I've ever had been around. And she was a Guy's White winner, and she is a Terry Scholar, which is like the Cook Foundation Award, but for Texas. And so, when I think about that, and I think about the service that we were doing in Phi Theta Kappa, I learned so much from all of that, and I can't promise any of you being inducted tonight that my experiences are going to be your experiences. But what I can tell you is, you talk to any other Phi Theta Kappans, you're going to hear stories that are funny, that are heartbreaking, that are inspiring, that are enlightening, because that is what Phi Theta Kappa is about. When I was telling you about Heba, the truth is I want to tell you about all the people that I was on the officer team with, because you may not be able to figure this out, but it's always been a little tough for me to make friends. So the fact that I was able to find people that I connected with so well, that's probably the thing that I love most about PTK. Oh, I'm not supposed to call it PTK. Well, that's the thing I love most about Phi Theta Kappa. Now, for those of you being inducted tonight, I welcome you wholeheartedly into this chapter. If you choose not to become involved, that's okay, because I wish for nothing but success and for nothing but joy in all your academic pursuits. And I look forward to seeing the heights that you guys take the chapter to. And I know this is true, because I remember this current officer team saying last year, we don't know if we can live up to what you guys did. Yeah, you are. And you will. And I've been like a big brother watching from afar, you know, sharing in their victories, both on a group level and an individual level. And I can't think of anything better than that, to see that. And I know that you guys are going to do the same. For the families and the friends that are joining us here tonight, it meant the world to me when I knew there was a loving face in the crowd. And I know it means the world to them. You could be doing something else right now, but you're here with us tonight. And that means everything to us. So thank you. Thank you very much for joining us. To the administration, the faculty, and the staff. Well, I'm not blowing smoke when I tell you, I wouldn't be up here without a lot of familiar faces I see. You know, Dr. Babu, I know I'm not supposed to get all personal. Thanks to you, I'm comfortable admitting that I love cats. And, you know, Dr. Pruitt, I never thought I'd meet anybody else that really liked Battlestar Galactica, so that was awesome too. So, but all joking aside, thank you for everything. Thank you for being here, because I know you could be doing something else, but you're here and you're supporting them, because they wouldn't be here without your efforts. And so I want everybody to enjoy the rest of the program. When the inductees come across the stage, please cheer loudly, not just for the one you're out here to support, but for all of them, because this is a fantastic accomplishment on their part. Please enjoy the rest of the program and have a wonderful and safe evening. Thank you very much.
We'd like to thank you, George, for coming out here in crazy traffic from St. Thomas and Cypress. And you're such an inspiration, and we love you.
The new members, the first step is to explain the society's symbolism. So please direct your attention to the emblem of the Golden Key, which is featured on the front of your program.
The emblem of Phi Theta Kappa is a golden slab that is keyed at the top and bottom. The golden field, or background, represents the nobility attained by those who achieve intellectual leadership. The Greek letters Phi Theta Kappa, featured on the band in the center of the key, represent wisdom, aspiration, and purity. The wreath is composed of oak leaves on the left and laurel leaves on the right. The oak leaves symbolize stability and strength of character. The laurel leaves, achievement and success.
Above the banded Greek letters is the head of Athena, who, in Greek mythology, is the goddess of learning. Below the band are the mystic Greek letters that refer to the light of knowledge and learning. The combined symbols of this elm demonstrates the high idealism of our organization and its devotion to scholarly ideals.
In addition to the golden key, the society also has a seal which is featured on the back of your program. The seal features the profile of Athena and stresses the importance that Phi Theta Kappa places on learning and wisdom. The seal also gives the date the society was founded.
Another important society symbol is white gold, which represents purity, the light of intellect, and the beauty of life. So, if its member is inducted, he or she will receive a white gold in honor of this idea and a newly formed connection to this society.
We will now induct the new Phi Theta Kappa members, inductees, please rise.
Honored Chapter President and fellow Phi Theta Kappa members, I am pleased to present you these candidates for membership in our Honor Society. These students have fulfilled all requirements for membership and have been selected because they have chosen scholarship, leadership, service, and fellowship as their hallmarks. I recommend them for acceptance into the Alpha Romeo chapter of Phi Theta Kappa International Honor Society of the two-year college.
You are about to be inducted into a scholarly fellowship which embraces two-year colleges, not only of your own state, but of the nation and the world. This fellowship is Phi Theta Kappa, and your chapter is Alpha Romeo. After induction, you will find among the members an atmosphere of scholarship to which you must give of yourselves in order that the organization may be meaningful to you. Please repeat after me. I state your name.
Do solemnly promise
on this 8th day of March 2016 to uphold the standards of Phi Theta Kappa, and to make this object a name, foremost in my mind. And I do solemnly pledge allegiance to my fellow members,
and promise to aid them
in all worthy endeavors.
In all worthy endeavors.
You may be seated. Will the first row of inductees please move to the center aisle and come to the right side of the stage?
Discussion of the awards that Alfa Romeo has won, but I want to mention also that the Texas region is exemplary, and many, many, many of the chapters involved have amazing projects. So I want y'all to keep that in mind. So I want to salute those of Lone Star College Sci Fair, our members from Blinn, from HCC. Their projects are amazing as well. Oftentimes, the difference between a chapter being number one and number two might be a half a point. So I do want us to acknowledge the excellence in the Texas region and to congratulate the other chapters as well. Amira Alzaben. Amira is transferring to the University of Houston, and she is majoring, well, she's exploring her various options at the moment, and she wants to give special thanks to her sister, her mom, Dr. Rollins, and Dr. Filatea. So now. Is majoring in nursing. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University. She wants to be a nurse practitioner. Tonight she wants to thank her husband and her children for all of their valuable support. She plans to transfer to Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Upon completing her Bachelor's of Science in Nursing, she wants to become a nurse. She gives thanks to her mom and dad, Christopher Carpio, for helping her continue to pursue her dreams. In the aerospace industry. He wants to thank his friends. He thanks Dr. Pruitt, Professor Vasselis, and especially his mom for her support and the sacrifices she made to get him to this point. Robert Ballister. Robert is majoring in accounting. He's still exploring his transfer opportunities, and he wants to become a CPA. He thanks his family and everyone who has made a difference in his life. Morgan is majoring in political science. She plans to transfer to Texas A&M University, and she wants to become a political scientist. She thanks her mom and dad and Curtis for their unending support and says, smiley face. Julia Bowman. Julia has a double major in biochemistry and food science. She wants to transfer to either Texas A&M University or to University of Texas in Austin. She wants to be a nutritionist. She thanks her mom and dad, as well as Ava Vasselis, who have been so supportive in her career goals. And will be applying for the Lone Star Radiology Program at the end of the semester for a fall 2016 start date. Upon completing the two-year program, She plans on working in the field while continuing her education to obtain additional certifications. She thanks her family for all of their encouragement and believing in her when she didn't herself. A special thanks to her husband for having to deal with certain attitudes on days prior to papers being due or test dates. Is majoring in biology. He plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University and he wants to become a medical doctor. He thanks his father, James C. Burnett, his mother, Regina S. Burnett. He says, thank you for all your love, and he says, I love you both. Andrew is majoring in computer science. He plans on transferring to Texas A&M University. He wants to be a software security expert. He thanks his family, his church and pastor, and all his professors at Lone Star College. Castellanos is majoring in criminal justice. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and she wants to become a criminologist or a CSI. She wants to thank her family and friends and for all of their love and support, and she sends out a big kiss and blows them love. And I'm sorry I messed up your name. Transferring to the University of Houston and complete her degree with a doctorate of pharmacy and become a practicing pharmacist. She thanks her parents, Professor John Crawford, Professor Melanie Younger, Professor V.C. Patel, and a special thanks to her brother Abdullah for helping with her assignments. Elizabeth is majoring in nursing. She plans on transferring to the Texas A&M Nursing School to become a nurse practitioner in the field of dermatology. She wants to thank her parents for always supporting her in all of her endeavors. Richard Alexander Daly is majoring in marine biology. He plans on transferring to Texas A&M Galveston or Corpus Christi, and he wants to become a marine biologist. He wants to thank his father, Emile Henri Daly, and his family, and he also thanks Monty Darland and Jackie Thomas from COATE and ITC. As she considers her options of various transfer institutions and thinks about potential career goals. She wants to thank Ms. Sherry White for inspiring her and fueling her love for acting, and she thanks her family for all of their love and support. Brittany Derringer. Brittany is majoring in veterinary medicine. She plans on transferring to Texas A&M University and wants to be a small animal veterinarian. She thanks her veterinarian, Dr. Clara Scott, for inspiring her to become a vet. And she thanks Dr. Scott for treating Brittany's animals like her own. And she thanks her family for always supporting her through college. Duran Saavedra is majoring in physical therapy. She plans on transferring to Texas Women's University and she wants to become a physical therapist and be an inspiration for others. She wants to thank God for her life, for giving her the strength to keep fighting every single day and for everything she's accomplished. She thanks her parents and siblings for giving her unconditional support. And finally, she thanks her friends, professors, and advisors, and the people who've helped her on this journey. majoring in journalism. She is still vetting various transfer institutions. She also is interested in photography. Ultimately, her career is going to combine those two passions. She wants to thank her mom and her dad and all those that are here in the audience with her to share this special moment. Marissa Gaines. Marissa's major is psychology. She plans on minoring in human resources. She wants to transfer to the University of Texas at Austin, and her main career goal is to work in human resources. She wants to thank her mother for helping her get through high school due to all of her medical setbacks. Thomas Garland is majoring in civil engineering, plans on transferring to the University of Houston, and wants to become a civil engineer. He wants to especially recognize and thank his parents and grandparents. Chad Garza is majoring in computer science. He plans on transferring to the University of Houston and wants to open a successful video game company. He wants to thank Haley Crandell, I'm not sure about the pronunciation, so Haley, I'm sorry if I messed that up, for all of your love and support. Renee Garza, Phyllis Price, and Michael Price for being the cornerstone that is family and pushing him towards success. He thanks Professor Stephanie Kelly and Melanie Dennis for believing in him and helping him become a better student. Daniel Gonzalez is majoring in business administration. He plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, where he is going to be involved in pre-med in order to continue on to medical school. He wants to thank his family for supporting his higher education endeavors. Katie Gressett is majoring in nursing. She plans on transferring to Mary Harden Baylor. Her career goal is to be a registered nurse. She wants to thank her family for being so supportive and her Savior, Jesus Christ, for giving her strength. Andrea Guzman is majoring in pre-medicine, plans on transferring to Baylor, and wants to be a surgeon. She gives thanks to her family and professors for believing in her and constantly supporting her. Rachel Hodgson is majoring in psychology. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University and she wants to be a child psychologist. She thanks her family, especially her mom, who constantly helps her study and often encourages her, and she also thanks her friends. Jordan Home. Jordan is majoring in computer science. He plans on transferring to the University of Texas at Arlington, and his career goal is to be a video game designer. He wants to thank especially Dr. Vasselis and recognizes Dr. Pruitt. Juan Hood. Juan is exploring the core curriculum as he considers a variety of potential career options. He wants to give special recognition and thanks to Georgia and Juan Hood. Mitchell Hunter is majoring in business with a focus on management information systems. He plans on transferring to the University of Texas. He wants to be the owner of a business, and he wants to give special thanks to his family members. Amber Renee Inman. Her major is accounting. She plans on attaining an associate's degree through Lone Star College and then continuing on to get a bachelor's degree at the University of Houston. She wants to thank her mother and father for always encouraging her to do her best. She thanks her boyfriend, Brett, and her little brother, Aaron, for all of their support. Vanessa Lucero Jimenez is majoring in business. She plans on transferring to the University of Houston and hopes ultimately to find her ideal dream job and enjoy life to its fullest. She wants to thank her family and her close friends. Katie Jones is majoring in veterinary technology and is still thinking about transfer options. She wants to be a licensed veterinary technician at a small animal clinic and is still considering potential specializations. She wants to thank her family for their support and encouragement and thank her friends for pushing her to be her best. She thanks all of the professors in the veterinary technology program for teaching her and moving her towards her future. Perry Jodell is majoring in accounting, plans on transferring to the University of Texas at Austin, or perhaps Texas A&M at College Station. She wants to be an accountant and a CPA in the future. She gives thanks to her family and friends. A special shout out to Mr. Thomas Young, Tommy Young, for making her love accounting even more. And she thanks Victor Masuki for making her enjoy economics. Jessica Kivlin is majoring in political science. And she's an awesome gal, and that's her husband. Specialize in events. She thanks her parents for their absolute faith in her and her husband and daughter for their constant support, love, and encouragement. Alexis Kulik. Alexis is majoring in communication studies. She plans on transferring to the University of Texas at Austin and wants ultimately to become an immigration lawyer. She gives special thanks to Professor Vassellis and Dr. Pruitt and Claire, and she wants to thank her parents as well. Shannon Lee. Shannon wants to complete her Associate of Arts and wants to become a petroleum data technician. She wants to recognize her dad, Carlton Freeman, and wants to recognize Rosalind Freeman, her mother, and thank them for their dedication and commitment to her success. Olmero Lopez is majoring in engineering electrical. He wants to transfer to the University of Houston, and his goal is to become a power electrical engineering tech. He wants to thank Lone Star College and especially the TRIO program. Kayla Lowry. Kayla is majoring in accounting. She wants to complete her bachelor's degree at either Texas A&M, the University of Houston, or perhaps Laterno. Her career is going to be accounting and bookkeeping from home because she wants to be a stay-at-home mom. She thanks her parents for providing her encouragement and support, as well as her close friends, and she recognizes Dr. Pruitt, Professor Vassellis, for being the best professors ever. Smiley face. Colin McAleer is majoring in business management and petroleum data technology. He plans on transferring to Texas A&M University, and he wants to be an entrepreneur. And he gives special thanks to his mother and father. Melissa Moe. Melissa is majoring in general science. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and she wants to be a medical examiner. She thanks her parents for all of their support, and thanks her high school English teacher, Jill Davison, for inspiring her to continue her education. Emily Nadine Morris is majoring in journalism. She is still exploring various transfer options and wants to be a journalist. She gives recognition and thanks to her parents, brother, sister, grandmother, and uncle. Cody Lee Mueller is majoring in geology. He plans on transferring to the University of Texas at Austin, and he wants to be a petroleum geologist. He is grateful to all of those who have helped him with his academic success. Krista Mullen is majoring in mechanical engineering. She hopes to transfer to the University of Texas at Austin, and she wants to be a mechanical engineer. She wants to thank her friends and family for all of their support and her professors for their hard work and dedication. Is majoring in anthropology. She plans on transferring to Texas State University and wants to be a forensic anthropologist. She thanks her family, including JR, Tina, Jenna, and Courtney. Annette Nodia is majoring in physical therapy. She plans on transferring to the University of Houston, and she wants to be the doctor in the family, smiley face. She wants to thank God for giving her this opportunity and thank her professors, Babu and Sean Tiffy, for making her education enjoyable. She thanks her family for their help, and especially Christy and her dad for the math tutoring. And she wants to thank Adam for his encouragement in being there for her. Of Houston. She wants to get her bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering and then continue towards a master's. She thanks God for being a source of strength and friendship in her life. And she wants to thank her wonderful friends and family for encouraging her and help her overcome self-doubts. And thank you, Professor Babu. Thank you, Dr. Tiffy, for all the laughs in class. And this is like a laughing face, and it's going to be hard for me to translate. Is majoring in computer engineering. She ultimately is going to transfer to the University of Houston. She wants a career in graphic design, creating 3D models for the engineering sector. She thanks her family and friends for supporting her every step of the way, and she also has a shout out to Professor Babu. Sciences. She plans on transferring to the University of Texas at Austin and wants to become an occupational therapist. She wants to thank all of her family and friends for being with her during this special moment. Randa Marie Nickerson is majoring in nursing. She's still vetting various transfer institutions, but ultimately her career goal is to become a flight trauma nurse. She gives thanks to God, her parents, church, and her church family. is majoring in education. She plans on transferring to the University of Houston and wants to get her bachelor's degree in bilingual education and become a bilingual teacher. She gives thanks to her mother, Rosa Rodriguez. She thanks Professor Doug Boyd and recognizes Professor Latoya Lewis. Kristen Reyes is majoring in nursing. She hopes to transfer to UTMB in Galveston. Her career goal is to become a nurse practitioner. She gives a big thank you to her family, her dad, mom, and Josh. And she says, thank y'all for pushing me and never losing faith. Dominique Riley. Dominique is majoring in veterinary medicine. She plans on transferring to Texas A&M Veterinary Medicine and Biomedical Sciences College. She wants to have a career as a veterinarian. She wants to thank her family and friends for being her rock. She thanks Professor Vasilis and Dr. Pruitt for all of the privileges they have given her through the Chancellor's Fellow Program. And she says to you, I would not be here, I would not be where I am without any of you. Thank you. Neri Rodriguez is majoring in fashion merchandising. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University and wants a career goal in the fashion world. She gives special thanks to the TRIO program, her mom and dad, An Phong, and all the wonderful people who have given her free food. Lauren Rosette is a science major. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and she wants to earn enough money with her major so she can write and publish a novel. She gives special appreciation and thanks to her mom, Sarah Rosette, and her dad, Glenn Rosette. Brandy Sanford is majoring in nursing. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and she wants to be a nurse anesthetist. She gives special thanks to her mom. Why? Just because she's awesome. Miranda Sanford is majoring in economics. She plans on transferring to the University of Houston, and she wants to be an attorney. She gives special thanks and recognition to her mom, Tammy Sanford, and her dad, Brian Sanford. She also wants to thank Lone Star College for offering her a stepping stone towards a bachelor's degree. Shauna Lynn Savage. Shauna is majoring in forensic science. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University and wants to pursue a career in forensic anthropology. She wants to recognize Dr. Lisa Lunsford, Professor Boyd, Dr. Hayward, Pat Lyon, all her family and friends, and I'm not sure about the pronunciation of this one, Ashley Mazgen. I hope I said that right here, if you're here, Ashley. Even if you're not, I still love you. Ethan Schultz. Ethan is majoring in computer science. He plans on transferring to the University of Texas at Dallas, and he wants to be a computer scientist. He gives special recognition and thanks to his mother and his father, as well as his brother Wyatt. Adoria Rajay Scott is majoring in engineering. She plans on transferring to Baylor University. She is an entrepreneur at heart and will pursue her own businesses. She thanks Cecilia Wright, Darwin Scott, Tanisha Scott, her grandparents, siblings, and all the other family members who support her. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and she wants to be an elementary or middle school teacher. She wants to recognize and thank tonight her family. Cameron Dawn Snyder. Cameron is majoring in electrical engineering. He plans on transferring to Texas A&M, and his goal is to work for a military contractor designing satellite communication equipment. He wants to thank his wife, Christy Lee Snyder, who has cheerfully encouraged him through his educational pursuits. Justin Stiles. Justin is a geoscience major. He plans on transferring to the University of Houston and ultimately will become a geologist. He gives special recognition to Rosario Stiles, his kids, Deborah Stiles, and Joyce Williford. Cheyenne Stokes. Cheyenne is majoring in graphic design. She is still checking out a variety of transfer institutions. Her ultimate career will be in graphic and web design. She wants to thank Professor Frau Bosky for making her first college experience so amazing. I can't wait to explore Germany with you this summer, she says to Frau Bosky. I think they just made fun of me in the faculty section for saying Frau Bosky. Lindsay Strasser. Lindsay is majoring in an occupational therapy assistant program. She plans on transferring to Texas Women's University. She wants to make a meaningful contribution as a certified occupational therapist assistant in order to help patients develop, recover, and improve the skills needed for daily living and working. She thanks her family for their love and support, and a special thank you to professors Dr. Tara Rupert and Stephanie Johnston for their wisdom, guidance, and enthusiasm. Connor Sombera. Connor is majoring in agricultural sciences. He's still exploring his transfer options and ultimately will pursue a career in agriculture. He wants to recognize and thank his dad, Dennis, as well as his mom, Renee. She plans on transferring to either Texas A&M or Baylor, and she wants to be a personal financial planner. She wants to recognize and thank Professor Vasselis, Dr. Pruitt, and Claire, as well as her parents and sisters. Victoria Tamas is majoring in business. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston. Her career goal is to be a successful businesswoman. She wants to thank her family for all the support and her friends for encouraging her. She wants to thank all of the professors that she's had for believing in her. Evelyn Tello. Evelyn is majoring in business marketing. She plans on transferring to the University of Houston, and her career goal is to be successful in the business world. She thanks her parents, her crazy friends, and her amazing professors. Elizabeth Thomas is majoring in theater. She plans on transferring to Abilene Christian University and completing her bachelor's degree there. Ultimately, she wants to be a high school theater teacher. She thanks her mom and dad, her siblings, Carolyn, Timothy, Stephen, and Sylvia, her vocal teacher, Andrea Lutes, as well as her best friends, Joseph and Ada, and she says, quote, "You guys rock my socks off." Lynn Tron is pursuing a major in the medical field. She's still vetting a variety of transfer options, and she hopes to have a career in medicine. Today, she wants to give a special thanks to her parents. and cytotechnology. She plans on transferring to the University of Texas at MD Anderson Cancer Center, where she wants to ultimately become a cytotechnologist. She thanks her sister and her professors. Darlene Trumpka. Darlene is planning on transferring to Sam Houston State University, where she is going to pursue a business administration major with a specialty in human resources. She hopes to be promoted within her current company to the HR benefits side. She wants to give special shout out to Jane Buckner of LSC Tomball Trio Program, and she thanks her son for his patience and support. Adriana Turbiartis is working towards an Associates of Applied Science in Medical Sonography. She wants a career as a medical sonographer. She wants to thank her parents for supporting her completely in her education. Justin Utz. Justin is majoring in nutrition. He plans on transferring to Texas State University. He wants to become a registered dietitian and find a new approach to curing cancer. He gives thanks and recognition to his mother and father, his sister Kelsey, and also Dr. Lisa Morales. Taylor Viatour. I had a hard time practicing her name, so I'm still not sure I said it right. Okay, so I'm just gonna go with Taylor. Taylor is majoring in math, and she's planning on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and she wants to have a career where she can make a difference in someone's life. She thanks her mom and dad for their endless support, as well as the rest of her family. Alexis Walton. Alexis is majoring in nursing. She wants to complete her RN and ultimately be the director of nursing at a hospital. She thanks her husband, Dusty, her kids, Cheryl and David Odom, her parents, Cheryl and David Odom, and her kids, Wesley and Madeline Walton, and she says, thank you all for supporting me on this journey through school. Kristen is majoring in business management. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University and wants to become a small business owner. She thanks her mom, Donna, for putting up with her, and she thanks Mitch for supporting her. Ronisha E. White. Ronisha is majoring in criminal justice. She plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University. Her career goal is to graduate with a degree in criminal justice and attend law school and work for the district attorney's office. She wants to thank her parents for never giving up on her and believing that she could finish what she started. She thanks her little sister for watching her daughters while I study, and she thanks her wonderful daughters for allowing her to read sometimes without asking her a million and one questions. He plans on transferring to Sam Houston State University, and his career goal is to work in a criminal investigation field for the Houston Police Department. He wants to thank his dad, mom, brother, and Aunt Christy, his grandparents, and his friends, Troy, Kyle, and John. He thanks Professor Brandon Lowry, Pat Lyon, Sherry White, Richard Becker, Barbara Hayward, Claudia Davis, and Dr. Jackie Thomas for helping him get through the first 2 years of college experience and giving him the best advice a college student could get. Nancy M. Wright is majoring in biology. She plans on transferring to the University of Texas, San Antonio, and become a physician's assistant. She thanks these following professors, Dr. McDowell, Dr. Galvin, Dr. Broadhurst, and she thanks her parents, Beverly and Jay Wright. Ashley Ziblatt is majoring in English. She plans on transferring to Texas A&M University, and she wants to be a fiction writer. She gives special thanks to God, her mother and father, as well as her grandparents. Will the new members of the Alpha Romeo chapter of Phi Theta Kappa please rise and receive your charge? To the cultivation of the well-reasoned life, a prelude to service and to honor. Congratulations. Let's give them one more round.
Personal congratulations to all the new members of Alpha Romeo for the academic excellence that has led to your induction into this prestigious honor society. I also want to recognize some very important members of the audience, the family and friends of those that have loved and supported each of the new members. New members, let's give them a round of applause. I also want to recognize the proud mama and papa faculty members and staff members that are here. They are cheering their students on. I didn't know that Professor Sabu was such a comedian in class, so those are good to hear. Listen, I really admire this chapter because of their commitment to work and projects. This past fall, this chapter held a cancer awareness seminar that many of you have heard about. As a family, as a person who has family that's been drastically affected by cancer, I really appreciate it in this manner. Those that attended the event was enlightening, and they gave a lot of hope to many people who were there. This chapter has continued their battle against cancer through fundraising for the We Like For Life event. If you look in your program, you will see how you will be able to participate. So as this ceremony draws to a close, I do want to talk about a few housekeeping items. After the reception, this chapter asks you to proceed over to the foyer for a short reception. This will give you an opportunity to continue the celebration. New members, please come back so that way you can take new pictures on the stage. So on behalf of Lone Star College Tom Ball, we want to thank you for coming out. So please remain seated as we have the reception of our new Phi Theta Kappa. Thank you.
Savior.